A New York Times editor suffered from one of the worst cases of foot and mouth syndrome that I have seen in a long time on Twitter this week. Robert O'Neill, who was a part of the Navy SEAL team that conducted the raid on Osama bin Laden's compound, and who claims to have fired the shot that killed bin Laden, posted a tweet of himself on an airplane, not wearing a mask, with the caption, "I'm not a pussy." Well, this New York Times editor, Dan Saltzstein, decided that he was going to lecture Robert O'Neill about not wearing a mask, but he did so in a way that showed he is very ignorant of who Robert O'Neill is. He tweeted, quote, "I don't know this guy, but counterpoint, you might just be because you're not willing to sacrifice and be a little uncomfortable for your fellow humans, including that Marine behind you." Now, I know that it's mandatory on most airlines to wear a mask, so if Robert O'Neill wants to fly, he probably should just wear the mask. That's my little caveat for this. But this Dan guy, the New York Times editor, accused him of not being willing to sacrifice and be uncomfortable. He said this to a Navy SEAL who trained for months to conduct this raid that killed Osama bin Laden. The idea that he is lecturing a veteran of that caliber about sacrifice and about comfort is so beyond absurd, and it just shows how out of touch these people are, because, you know, normal Americans who are on Twitter, conservatives who are on Twitter, they all know who Robert O'Neill is, they recognize the name, they follow his tweets, they have a good idea of his service record. And then you have this New York Times editor who is supposed to be some guy who's in the know, who's all about the news, and he's spouting off this ignorant take to a Navy SEAL veteran who killed bin Laden. The whole thing is just further evidence of how these people really just live in their own bubble, and also how snarky they are. I mean, it's one thing to politely ask someone to wear a mask. Like, I get it. Some people are terrified. I don't live my life that way. I'm not terrified of the virus, and I don't do stupid stuff like wear my mask when I'm outside in the open air. But if I were on an airplane and someone politely asked me to wear a mask, I'd probably do it just to try to be a nice fellow citizen. Whatever. It's not a big deal. But he goes into it with this snarky lecturing tone about sacrifice and comfort and about, you know, just being very condescending. And when people treat me like that, when it comes to the mask wearing, that's when I get upset and I'm like, I don't want to do this for you now. You know, I don't want to make you feel comfortable because you've been such an asshole to me. So I think if we all just started treating each other with a little bit more respect instead of doing this I'm better than you woke bullshit, then everyone would be a lot better off. If you've been feeling a little black-pilled lately, feeling like our culture is all going to hell and that our society is run by a bunch of elite pedophiles who don't care about your children and actually want to actively hurt them, then I'm afraid to tell you that you might actually be right, because Netflix has been promoting this new film called Cuties, which is about 11-year-olds who are in a twerking dance competition. For those of you who are unfamiliar, twerking is basically shaking your butt to music. It's a very sexual form of dance, and it's definitely inappropriate for any children to be partaking in. And the most disturbing part of this promotion, perhaps, was the photo that they used to share this film, or share the fact that this film was going to appear on Netflix, because it featured four young girls who were around the age of 11. One of them was on all fours. The other was in the process of shaking her behind, and another one was posed in sort of a squatting, very sexual position, all four of them wearing very skimpy outfits with the midriffs exposed. And this film is, again, called Cuties. So that was disgusting, and people were rightfully appalled by this, and they started going after Netflix for promoting this film and even allowing it to appear on their streaming platform. Netflix actually eventually apologized for the promotional photo, saying, quote, "We're deeply sorry for the inappropriate artwork that we used for Cuties. It was not okay, nor was it representative of this French film, which won an award at Sundance. We've now updated the pictures and description." Now let's go ahead and break down this apology, because you'll quickly see that it's actually bullshit. So first of all, the inappropriate artwork, where did it come from? Were these stills from the movie? Because if so, if this was just pictures that they took from the movie itself, then that shows it was in fact representative of the film, because it's a scene that appears in the film. if this is not a still from the film, and they actually went out of their way to pose the girls like this for a promotional photo, then that's even more disgusting because they knew exactly what they were doing and they knew that they were making this photo in a way to make these girls appear sexual. They also point out that the film won an award at Sundance, as if that is supposed to make us feel better. Oh, well, it's just art. See, it was even awarded at Sundance at a very prestigious film festival. No, actually, that's worse because it shows that it's not just a Netflix problem. This is a Hollywood problem. This is an art problem where young children are routinely sexualized and seen through a pedophilic gaze because this is an industry that is filled with disgusting people who exploit children and exploit sex to make money. That is sick. And it's a reality. It's a sad reality that our entertainment industry, particularly Hollywood, is filled with pedophiles who use children for their own ends. So many of these poor young people who come up through places like Disney and Nickelodeon end up being abused and taken advantage of. And then they grow up with these awful problems. I mean, you see people like Lindsay Lohan and the Olsen twins and all of these poor children who are just exploited by adults who should know better, but use them for their own ends. And Netflix is perpetuating this problem by showing this film Cuties. And then when you go and actually read the description of this film and watch the trailer, you will discover that it's a very anti-religious film. Because the whole point is that this 11-year-old girl who wants to join this twerking dance team is in a family that is Muslim and very traditional, and her parents don't want her to be sexualizing herself at her very young age. But somehow this family, who is rightfully concerned about their child getting involved in this dance crew, is painted as, of course, the crazy religious people who are oppressive and misogynistic. It couldn't possibly be that they actually care about their child. And it's very demonic, actually, that this is a film that promotes this idea of the hypersexualization of women and young women and children at the expense of the religious traditions that make attempts to protect them. And everything about this is just so disturbing. It's really indicative of where our culture has gone over the past 10, 20 years. Where it is cool, it is normal for young women to be used in this way, to expose themselves in this way for clout or for money. And people who oppose this are, of course, called prudes. They're accused of being, sexist or misogynist because they're worried about the fact that women are being exploited. And of course, we saw this song come out recently with Cardi B called WAP, which stands for Wet Ass Pussy, and I'm sure you all have seen the videos of people reading the lyrics, which are absolutely sickening. And this is something that was considered empowering by women. I mean, some of the artists involved in this song were in videos talking about how it made them feel empowered, that they were able to talk about sex in such a debasing and really, you know, a way that emphasizes the lowest common denominator. This is not sensuality. This is not romance. This is just pure dirty sex, this song. And it's things like this and things like this Netflix film Cuties that show the degradation of our culture, the exploitation of our children. And I really just can't emphasize enough how concerning this is, how disturbing it is. And it really just... I see it and it just depresses me. Everything about it is depressing. And there has to be a way that we can work to get our culture back to a place where we have respect for women's bodies and we don't expose them unnecessarily. We have respect for children and we try to protect our children. And that is really the call to patriots, is we have to do something about this. We cannot allow these tech companies, these entertainment companies, to destroy our families and destroy our culture. I cannot emphasize this strongly enough.